Imagine waking up tomorrow and stepping outside into a world that feels subtly wrong. Not dangerous, not chaotic, just strangely empty. You don't know why at first the sky is clear, the wind is normal, the streets look the same. But something in the air feels off, like the world is holding its breath. You walk through your neighborhood, pass by gardens, parks, flowers, but there's a stillness you can't explain, a silence that shouldn't exist. And then you realize it. There is no buzzing, no small flashes of movement drifting between flowers, no flickers of yellow, no gentle hum, no vibrating sound in the air, nothing. The bees are gone, all of them. Agricultural experts break down on live TV trying to explain what the next few months will look like. Because this isn't just an environmental mystery, it is the beginning of the biggest biological collapse in human history. Every apple blossom, every blueberry bloom, every almond flower, every avocado bud, all of them are blooming for the last time. They look alive, they look beautiful, but they are functionally dead. Without bees transferring pollen, the flowers are nothing more than empty shells. They bloom, they wither, they fall, they die, and the world doesn't replace them. But here's the most chilling part. This isn't science fiction. This is the direction we are already moving. But unlike the scenario we imagine, we can still stop this. Bees can recover. They can rebuild. They can return stronger than before if we give them what they need. They are architects of the natural world, builders of ecosystems, guardians of food chains, carriers of life between blossoms, messengers between plant and planet, the heartbeat of the biosphere. And if humanity ever wakes up in that silent world, a world with no buzzing, no pollinators, no bees, the question we ask won't be, why did the bees disappear? It will be, why didn't we listen when we still had time?